Over the next 18 months or so, over 20,000 households across Britain will receive an invitation to take part in our study called Natsal. This is the National Survey of Sexual Attitudes and Lifestyles, and they'll receive an invitation looking something like this and asking them to take part in the survey. Now, Natsal 2010 is the third of the National Surveys of Sexual Attitudes and Lifestyles, now the biggest surveys of their kind worldwide. The first survey took place in 1990. It involved nearly 19,000 people across the length and breadth of Britain, and it was designed to help us understand how HIV might spread in Britain and how its spread might be prevented. But it also involved all sorts of other areas of sexual health and lifestyles and helped us to improve services and education. In 2000, we undertook another survey. And in that survey, we were able to show that risky behaviour had increased between 1990 and 2000, probably as people began to feel a little bit less concerned about HIV. And our results were absolutely consistent with the data that we'd shown between 1990 and 2000, that there was an increased risk of acquiring a sexually transmitted infection. There were more sexually transmitted infections. And we were able to compare the 2000 results with the results of our first survey, which were published in book form in 1994, and all the detailed results are in this book. In 2000, we were also able to do something else entirely new, which was to invite people to provide a urine sample, which we tested for chlamydia. That's a sexually transmitted infection, a very common one. And we were able to show for the first time that there was as much infection without symptoms in men as there was in women. And these data were really important in helping the design of the chlamydia screening program, which is now being undertaken in young people aged 16 to 24 and includes both men and women. Now, this year, we're going to carry out a new survey, the 2010 survey, and that's also got new elements to it. For the first time, we're going to include a much broader age range, so we'll be including people from 16 all the way up to 74, and we've undertaken some interviews with older people and found that they're happy to take part. And we found that we also want to ask them more about the relationship between general health and physical health and mental health and sexual well-being. The difference between our surveys and the kind of surveys that you might undertake by filling in a magazine survey is that we don't rely on people who self-select to take part in surveys. We actually design a random sample. So when we select households and the households we write to will be selected entirely randomly. And the reason we do that is we want to get the views of people from across the length and breadth of Britain. We want to get people from all walks of life. So we have a really true picture of how lifestyles vary across Britain. Now, those households are visited by our team of professional interviewers from the National Centre of Social Research, who are our partners and collaborators in this research. And they visit the homes and invite a randomly selected person to participate. And our respondents are able to answer the questions by tapping them into a laptop computer to really ensure confidentiality and privacy when the survey takes place. So we're looking forward now to going into the field with the main study over the next 18 months and to inviting a number of people to participate. And we rely very much on not only the funding and the research team, but our strong team of interviewers and, of course, the thousands of people who participate.